But when we built the Hong Kong Center, that was the first center in the Far East. And when Gurudev came and saw the work in Hong Kong by that time, and he was not into building centers and all that. People say, oh, build a center. He said, why? First you do some activities, then we'll build a center. But seeing that the Balvi are children in such small flats, he said, we should have a center. And that is also amazing when you see Antar-yāmine, how everything is orchestrated. Yami means one who orchestrates everything within our bosom. In Bhagavad Gita, also, at the end, Krishna says, Ishvara lies in the hearts of everyone. And everyone is linked like spokes of a wheel. And he makes everyone function. To think also that what do we can do or what do we do? Somebody may say, I started this or I started that. But as a devotee, we know that nothing we could do without his name or without him doing everything. He came to Hong Kong. And very interesting, when I look at the dates also, you wonder, was it orchestrated? Is he not the Yami, the controller of everything? Inside us also, we think it is our thought, our idea, our work, our... But really speaking, how it is? The day he came to inaugurate the Chinmaya Seva Ashram in Hong Kong, it was 21st April. And he came to inaugurate the center there. He was passing from Australia via Hong Kong to India. Or was it, I think, from Australia to Hong Kong, just transiting all the way from there to go to USA at that time. So he came there, and ashram, Hong Kong is all flats. He first only said, people will not be able to accommodate here, book a hall. In one day, in a few hours, we booked a hall and we were there. And that is the time, and he insisted that I will introduce him. Because I've never spoken in front of him. I have to speak in front of your guru, one thing is very difficult, but in front of him, who's Angla Bhasha Viduttama. But I think by then, Gurudev said something, you just do it, you know, it's going to be successful. After all, he's Antar-yāmine, he'll do it. So he said, you introduce, and he insisted. He said, my brahmachari only is going to introduce me. There are other very good speakers and all that. No, he will introduce me. I didn't say anything, but I was hoping that somebody else would introduce, some stalwart would introduce, but no, he will introduce me. And when he just tells it before, I had only a few minutes, and when I thought about it, that we are starting our center on 21st April, and that day only I had got a phone call from a very loving Amma from Coimbatore. Talk about coincidences. He's coming from Australia to Hong Kong to inaugurate the center, and I get a message from Coimbatore that, look at his passport, 21st April is his birthday, but actually his Indian calendar birthday was his 75th birthday, which we are going to have a grand Swarna Tula Bharam, which was supposed to be on 8th May, because we said today is his Indian calendar or his nakshatra, you know, his star birthday. So 75th birthday of his. The first center in the, other than USA, first center actually in the Far East was being inaugurated. And when I look back at the dates, exactly 1 year before he'd come to Hong Kong, and when he saw the Balvihar children and so many study groups, and he declared, it was 21st April, he declared that we will have a center in Hong Kong. I look at the they, Chinmaya Mission was not registered. In Hong Kong was 1 year before, and our article of memorandum was 21st April. So when I went up onto the dais to introduce Gurudev, I started off that. That 5 years ago, from this very Hong Kong, on 21st April, one youngster was picked up and sent to the ashram. The day I joined the ashram was also 21st April. The day my first book, Ikonkar, 1st April, he gave me the permission to join the ashram. 21st April, I joined the ashram. My book, Ikonkar, first commentary with his beautiful letter in it, was released in Sidbari by Guruji at his Samadhi. And on 21st April in Delhi, when I'm doing Hanuman Chalisa, there it was released. So, is it a coincidence on his 75th birthday? Who is the Antar-yāmi, one who orchestrates everything? Now, really speaking, for any project, money doesn't come. The intellectuals don't give money. They're very happy to gain knowledge, but they're very rational. It's the emotional devotees who love and just see the beauty of the work, they pour. So really speaking, donations are very low, always. But everybody wants, center we should have. Yeah, center we must have. Our children should benefit. What comes is very little. Anyway, the devotees who are there of Gurudev, they give very generous interest-free loans, and we immediately, because when the center comes, you have to buy it there and then. So some give donations, etc. But 2 million we had to pay back as loan. And one devotee who had given 1 million said that when this loan is paid back to me, I will give you that money, Gurudev. You know, I don't know why he had to go zigzag. He could have given it at that time. And when we gave it, but he said no, we will do it this way. In 1, we inaugurated the center. 1993, of course, Gurudev Mahasamadhi took place. And 1993 also he came to Hong Kong. And he was telling me, pay him off soon. Many times we go to Manila, he would give me the money. He said, go, you know, pay. I said, no, Gurudev. Hong Kong will give you, but will not take from you. Please, Gurudev, no. You have many, many centers to look after. You're not going. We will manage it on our own. It's a very affluent city. They should manage on their own. We'll manage our own. This gentleman also, his wife told me that you tell Gurudev, why are we asking from anybody? We will give. Even there, look at his love. I went, she told me, I had to tell him. She said, did you tell Gurudev? I said, auntie says that all of them are uncle aunties for us in India, you know. So I said, auntie says that why are we asking for people? People give little and they'll talk too much. She says her husband is rich enough, he's so devoted, he will give everything. Now he had given it as a loan, you know. Very generous man. He had given it as a loan and he said also that I'll give it. But we should not ask, he will give it anyway. I went to Gurudev and I told Gurudev, Gurudev, she says like that. That time he didn't say, I'll give it to Gurudev, but she said, you know he will give it. He's so generous and he loves Gurudev. So I told Gurudev, it's true, public will not give. But she's told me that she will give that money. And Gurudev said, I know. Because that man always used to say, everything I have is Gurudev's given. I really had nothing. He says, I know. But let everyone feel that they have put a brick in the wall. So that they also feel that my children are benefited. I did something for it. I know people don't give. Then if there's any balance, I know he will give it, you know. But that his was. And that's why today even Chinmaya Mission does not run on 1 person, 2 person, 3 person. Little. Let everybody get a chance because they don't know what blessings they get. In 1993, when he came, this man told him that when Hong Kong pays me back, I will give you that money for India mission work and all that. So Gurudev said, my boy will give it back. My boy will be and telling me. And he only took me to London and all these places. And by the time really all the amounts had come, it was only to be transferred to this. And he would say, my boy will pay it. And he used to tell me, you pay it, he's going to give that 1 million, no? And I was with him in London. From London, he went to USA. By the time I came back to Hong Kong, it was Diwali. And I handed over that check to him. I never even till today made an announcement. I mean, I've told the story, but made an announcement in Hong Kong, which would be such a matter of pride that we've paid off all the loans. You know? And that day, because any small, because another word will come, utsaha vardhakaya namaha. Every small thing, he just encouraged you, made you enthusiastic. So encouraging he was. You can do it. So he kept on doing, and really speaking, everything is because of his name only was coming. He only took me to those places. You know, so I, that day when I handed over the check to him, it was Diwali day. It was a matter of great joy and pride that his work has been accomplished. I went to my room after paying. I didn't have any expression on my face because he was no longer physically there. And not that I feel that he's not there. And everything before his samadhi had already come. It was only to be transferred. And by the time I go there to give it to him. But his samadhi already took place. And I know how thrilled and happy he would be. And I know a letter would have come that, you know, I'm so glad it is done, or you did it, or whatever. It was not about anything, but just to get a word from him. It was like, I know, and he would have given a pat on my back, you know, and said that. So I just went to my room, and that's, even in samadhi and all that, it was not that, you know, that much sadness. I just went to my room, and I said, if that check would have gone to him, you know, so much he was working, and I know he would have written a letter, it would be just one line. And that I miss, you know. And with tears I went into my room. Tear means just a little tear in my eyes. And his photograph was right in front of me, which was signed by him. And I entered inside. And those are rare moments, you know, it's not your thoughts. And not I'm schizophrenic either. Yeah. Those rare moments, you hear his roaring voice in you. And you can't make it up. There's no time to make it up or imagine it. You know, it's nice you imagine. You have this conversation in your mind. And there are some people who think that the conversation is very real. I just said in my mind, Gurudev, I wish you were here, you know. And I heard this sound. Buddhu, don't you think I know? I tell you, after that day, I never ever thought he's not. I know it, of course, but I never thought he's not there. This call is Antar-sakshi, and Antar-yāmine. Who orchestrated everything? Everything was orchestrated by him. Yami translated as controller, but as Krishna explains in the Gita, that everything is orchestrated within ourselves by him. Because only with his presence can anything move. He says, don't you think I am seeing right now? After that, there's nothing to talk about, nothing to feel sad about, because moment to moment, if you can recognize, he's watching over us. That's Antar-sakshine namaha, Antar-yāmine namaha. And those who go with me to Siddhvadi, I'll tell you something else also. No, what about we don't go? But you will understand only if we go there. So that's why I'm going to tell you there. Remind me, okay? You won't have to remind me. I know I'm going to tell you, but. Yeah. So Antar-sakshine namaha, Antar-yāmine namaha. I've linked these both up because everything is orchestrated because of the presence of consciousness, without which neither your eyes can see, your ears can hear, your eyes can function also, or your tongue can speak. Nothing is possible until and unless that consciousness is there. And that is called as Chinmaya. Pervaded by consciousness, and without consciousness, nothing can function.